Command and Conquer is one of my favorite game series. We can take part in the battles of the Nod and the GDI as commanders. On the other hand, Kane probably didn't just want to use sheer force to achieve his goals. There's probably a large-scale, successful intrusion attempt in the background that I didn't see people talking about. This intrusion spans several games over the years. Command and Conquer 3 starts by destroying a Philadelphia station with full of GDI overhead. Except for someone, Director Redmond Boyle. Redmond Boyle's life was spared specifically at Kane's request. In games, we think, because he knew he was going to be a bad leader. But what if there's more to it than just a bad leader? He is Kane's man. We know he's not a knowledgeable person, but there's a part in the game that I think shows he's done a task as an agent. An important part of Kane's plan was to detonate a liquid Tiberium bomb, but Nod's means were few to do that. He needed a GDI ion cannon to make the plan reality. However, even the lower GDI leaders knew it would be dangerous to use the weapon. It wouldn't have happened if Boyle hadn't specifically asked for it. When this scene is in the game, it looks that he's nervous, that he's just fulfilling Kane's wish to demand the use of the ion cannon. His body language is telling you. Then let's jump to the next war. Years go by and Boyle was the top leader for a long time. And he shaped things in GDI and in the planet. Which is a mess now. Kane offers a bargain, brings the Tacitus, shows up in front of GDI leaders. It's not a small risk, but he dares, maybe because he knows he's meet with his people in reality? At least part. He says with a grin, brothers, sisters, to the deadly, hated enemy? No. He probably knew that his own people were already there, at least in part. Then the final game takes rather weird twists. We may have gotten used to the fact that there are internal fights inside the Nod. But now, to our great dismay, the GDI commander is attacking his own leadership. Why? Because we found out by accident that our superiors have a contact with Kane through a secret channel and they help him. The overthrow of the leadership will not work. But we will still be freed, because there are those who do not support the GDI top level secretly. In the last fight, this top leaders will still try to help Kane, but they will remember us that there are renegade commanders, those who do not listen to them, and hope that Kane keeps the promise he made to them. So it is clear that the GDI leadership is helping Kane secretly, and I think they were Kane's people in reality, and their infiltration started under Redmond Boyle's leadership. Because Redmond Boyle was actually Kane's agent.